In the name of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we welcome you into His presence. And on behalf of our vicar, the Venerable John Agboro, we welcome you. And we pray that as we celebrate together at the table of the Lord, the power in the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ will refresh us, empower us, and heal us. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Is there to prove
Jesus said to him, Thomas, because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen, yet have believed. I will bless the Lord at all times. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. This is the day which the Lord has made. Together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory in excelsis. Glory be to God. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one God. For you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. This is the fourth commandment. And the second is like, namely this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Hear the words of comfort our Savior Christ says to all who truly turn to him. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Hear what St. Paul says. This saying is true and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John says. If anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all people, meekly kneeling upon our knees. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbors in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We have not sufficiently walked according to the mind of Christ. We have named the name of Christ, but have not departed from iniquity. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve in newness of life to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. The collect, the readings, and the word. The Lord be with you. Almighty Father, who in your great mercy made glad the disciples with the sight of the risen Lord, give us such knowledge of his presence with us that we may be strengthened and sustained by his risen life and serve you continually in righteousness and truth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Please sit back.
epistle is taken from 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 3 to 9. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that does not fade away, reserved in heaven for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith for salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while, if need be, you have been grieved by various trials, that the genuineness of your faith, being more precious than gold that perishes, though it is tested by fire, may be found to praise, honor, and glory at the revelation of Jesus Christ, whom having not seen you love, though now you do not see him, yet believing, you rejoice with joy inexpressible and full of glory, receiving at the end of your faith the salvation of your souls. This is the word of the Lord.
The continuation of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ as recorded by St. Luke. Now on the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they and certain other women with them came to the tomb bringing the spices which they had prepared. but they found the stone rolled away from the tomb. Then they went in and did not find the body of our Lord Jesus. And it happened, as they were greatly perplexed about this, that behold, two men stood by them in the shining garments. Then, as they were afraid and bowed their faces to the earth, they said to them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Remember now how he spoke to you when he was still in Galilee, saying, 'The Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified, and the third day rise again.' And they remembered his words. Then they returned from the tomb and told all these things to the 11 and to all the rest. It was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and other women with them who told these things to the apostles. And their words seemed to them like idle tales, and they did not believe them. But Peter arose and ran to the tomb, and stooping down, he saw the linen cloth lying by themselves, and he departed, marveling to himself at what had happened." This is the gospel of Christ.
Shall we bow down our heads in prayer? May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen. Shall we be seated, please? Please, I'd like to appreciate our vicar and archdeacon. Sir, we appreciate all that you do in this church. And it's our prayer that God, in his infinite mercies, will shower upon you and your family, your wife and children, the best of his blessings. In Jesus' name, amen. Our sermon this morning is titled, "The Christian's Living Hope." And our scriptural reading is taken from the gospel, which has already been read to us. You see, in the journey of life, many people go through a lot. Many people go through tribulations, persecutions, troubles, challenges of different types. Again, in our individual lives, there are also challenges. There are several people that are trusting God for various things. Some are trusting God for the fruit of the womb. Some are trusting God for wives. Some are trusting God for husbands. Many for jobs. Others for breakthrough of different kinds. Others for expansion in business, for promotions, for change of jobs. It could be anything, for exams, for those who are students. Some are waiting for certain approvals, and that is what they're trusting God for. Some have marital issues. Now, it could also be a child that has gone the other way, and you're asking God for restoration. Some various type of sickness. Now, one thing I want to tell us is that irrespective of the challenge, we must put our hope in God. I want to read from Psalm 42, verse 5. The book of Psalms, Psalm 42, verse 5. "Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God. Hope in God. For I shall yet praise him, and for the help of his countenance." Another dimension to this is that we all have hope of eternity, of going to heaven. If you look at the gospel that was read to us, you see the truth is that for the believer, there is hope that beyond the grave, because Jesus Christ has opened the door to heaven for us by his death and resurrection, that will go to heaven. There was a certain man in the book of Job, chapter 1, called Job. It came to pass that, you know, God allowed the devil to toy with him. So the devil took his possessions, he took all his assets. And to compound matters, he took his 10 children, 7 sons and 3 daughters. As if that was not enough, the devil inflicted him with sores all over his body. But what kept him alive and strong was his hope in God. In the book of Job, chapter 2, verse 9 and verse 10. Job chapter 2, verse 9 and 10. Job had an encounter with his wife. Then his wife said to him, "Do you still hold fast to your integrity?" He said, "Curse God and die." The suffering was too much. But Job said unto her, "You speak as one of those foolish women speaks. Shall we indeed accept good from God, and we shall not accept adversity?" In all of this, Job did not sin against with his lips. Let me tell you something. Hope is the oxygen of our soul. Hope is the sustainer of life. You see, scientific research have told us that it is possible for a man or a woman to stay between 3 and 7 days without water. And that a man or woman can live for 40 days without food. Please, I beg you in the name of God, don't try it. It's just what the scientists have said. But let me tell you, whenever hope is lost, sometimes it can lead to what we call depression, because you are in a situation of hopelessness. And depression is dangerous. It is a mood disorder. That is why you will see somebody that is well-dressed, not that he's mad, he's not suffering from neurosis or psychosis. He will go to Tepmenland and want to jump into the lagoon because the person has lost hope. If you go to Google, you will see one woman, she's a socialite. She wanted to jump into the lagoon but was rescued. Another one wanted to jump, was rescued. There are people who are not rescued who jumped into the lagoon because of situation of hopelessness. We must learn to put our hope in God. Let me tell you, if you put your hope in God, it attracts help from God. Psalm 121, verses 1 and 2. Psalm 121, verse 1 and verse 2. Please, scream master. "I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help." Verse 2, say, "My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth." Yes, our help comes from God. Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 4. Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 4. The Bible says, "But for him who is joined to all the living, there is hope. For a living God, dog is better than a dead lion." Let me tell you, once there is life, there is hope that your tomorrow will be all right. There's also hope that your tomorrow will be better. There was a story in the Bible, in the book of Acts, chapter 3, from verse 1 to 8. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 3, from verse 1 to 8. Incidentally, because of time, we may not be able to read, but I will summarize the story. There was a certain man who was lame, who was always stayed at the gate of the temple. One day, Peter and John were passing. They were going to church. The Bible says during the hour of prayer. And Peter looked at him and came close to him. In fact, what he was expecting was alms from Peter. But Peter said to him, "Silver or gold I do not have, but what I have I will give you." He said, "In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk." And Peter held onto his hands and pulled him up. And he rose up and he walked. Please, there are a few salient points I would just like to pick from this book of Acts of the Apostles, from this story of this lame man. Number one, this man had a problem that defined him. But they were referring to him as the lame man, the crippled man. You know, even in the Bible, in the book of Mark chapter 10, there was a man called Bartimaeus. Because he was blind, his problem defined him. They were calling him blind Bartimaeus. By the mercies of God, your problem will not define you in Jesus' name. I thought I would hear a louder amen. Amen. The second salient point is that that man was stagnant. You know when you get to the traffic light, there are three lights that you see. You see red, yellow, green. This man was under red light for many years. They say, stay one place. The third one was that the siege he had in his life reduced him to a beggar. Number four, very sad. He was very close to the temple, but he could not tap the anointing from the temple. So sad. Number five, he was clearly a liability. People carried him every day to the temple and carried him back to and fro every day to beg for alms. Number six, he needed help. However, nobody he came across would give him a permanent solution to his challenge. They were just giving him money. The seventh salient point is that he had expectations. Just like every one of us, we also have our own expectations. What he wanted was money, or what money could buy. Interestingly, God exceeded his expectation. Let's still dwell on this number seven. With regards to expectations, there are three possibilities when it comes to expectations. One, God can give you exactly what you ask for. If you remember in the book of the story of Elijah and Elisha, when Elijah was to be taken away, Elijah was following him all over the place. And he asked him, what do you want me to do for you? And he said, let me have a double portion of your anointing. God answered him and gave him exactly what he asked for. The second point is that God can exceed your expectations. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 11, there's this woman called Anna. Anna prayed one prayer and said, God, give me one son, one child, one male child, and I will offer him back to you. God exceeded her expectation. God not only gave her a son, but gave her five extra children, three sons and two daughters. So God can exceed your expectation. Now, the third one is the one that interests me very much. Let me tell you, if you have a relationship with God, God can give you even what you have not asked for, because he is God. You remember David? David never asked to become king, but he became a king. You also remember Mary? Mary never asked to be the mother of Jesus, but it came to pass. Let's move back to where we are, number eight, the eighth salient point. The lame man encountered many men of God, but none could give him a permanent solution. However, the day he encountered Peter and John, his story changed. I want to ask all of us, brethren, whether you're here or listening online, who is your own Peter? Who is your Peter? Who is your John? Your Peter must not necessarily be a man of God, but he must be a man from God. He must be somebody that God has sent to you. Your Peter is your helper. Let me tell you, don't think because you are a millionaire that you don't need help. Your helper may appear, and God will move you from being a millionaire to a billionaire. God can do all things. Nothing is impossible with him. I want to decree upon our lives this morning, because the Bible says that you shall decree a thing and it shall be established. Wherever your Peter is, God will arrange a meeting between you and him and her in the name of Jesus. Now, after after Peter lifted up that lame man, the Bible says that his feet and ankle bones gained or received strength. I also want to decree upon our life that physically, God will strengthen you. You are not seeing amen, no? I'm decreeing upon your life that physically, God will strengthen you. Spiritually, God will strengthen you. Financially, God will strengthen you. In the name of Jesus. The lame man walked out of his limitation. By the message of God, every one of us here, and even those listening online, we will walk out of our limitations in the name of Jesus. You remember I told you he was on red light. But clearly, when Peter lifted him up, his red light turned to green. By the mercies of God, everybody that has been under red light, it will change to green in the name of Jesus. Let me tell you what happened. After the man regained his sight, he entered the temple. And if you read the Bible in verse 8 of that scripture, the Bible says that he praised God. I pray for every one of us this morning that all the challenges we have will end in praise in the name of Jesus. All we need is to have our hope in God, and he can do all things for us. Psalm 42 verse 11. Psalm 42 verse 11. Why are thou cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted in me? The Bible says, hope in God. I will stop here. In conclusion, in the book of Proverbs, chapter 23, verse 18, I will read from King James Version. The Bible says that for surely there is an end, and the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. I decree upon your life that your expectation will not be cut off in Jesus' name. Please put your trust in God and put him to test. He will clearly manifest his power upon your life in the name of Jesus. And I pray for you for this week and for the rest of the month that the Lord will bless you and keep you, that the Lord will make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace in the name of God the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Let us reaffirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray.
still in the mood of prayer. Who is like unto thee, O Lord? Who is like unto thee, O Lord? Among the gods, who is like thee? You are glorious in holiness and fearfully praises. All great to in wonders, alleluia. I just want you to bless the name of the Lord. Thank the Lord for who he is, for really who is like unto thee. He's the only one that had risen from the dead. Praise him for who he is. Thank him for his mercies upon you. Because the Bible tells us in Psalm 141, he says that we praise the Lord continually. We don't have anything. And the word of God says that God inhabits the praises of his people. Remember, for all what you have, your life today is because of the Lord. Thank him and praise him. For the Lord is good. He's our God, he's our maker, our creator. And that is what he needs right now. The praises of his people is what keeps him going. And maybe you don't understand where that song came from. Exodus chapter 15, verse 1. When the children of Israel, they were faced with the Red Sea. And then the chariots from the Egypt were at their back. What did they do? They busted out in praises. Talk to the Lord this morning and say, Father, every Red Sea ahead of me, Lord, it will be parted. Lord, talk to the Lord and say, Father, because you are mighty, you are the man of war, nothing is too difficult for you. You can do all things. Father, I put my trust in you, for there is no one like you. And ask the Lord at this time, because the Lord says, every man has his own ability. There's a tool, there's an ability in everyone. In Matthew 25, verse 15, he says that. But for the fact that Moses had a rod, talk to the Lord and say, Father, inspire me and open my eyes, that I will see that tool, that ability you have given to me. Every ability that you have is unto life, is living and to the glory of God. For your own prosperity, that is what it is. Ask the Lord this morning, what is it that I have deposited in me? I don't even know. Lord, open my eyes, open my inner eyes. Remember, we just heard the story of blind Bartimaeus from the sermon. Remember, he was blind, but with his inner eyes, he saw Christ. Either from the noise or anywhere, but he knew Christ was around. Ask the Lord this morning, Lord, inspire me. Father, inspire me. Further, greater, in the name of Jesus. This is the first Sunday in the month of April. In your own words, speak to that month. The month of April, we are told, is the month of abundance, is the month of protection, is the month of restoration, is the month of increase, is the month of liberty. Ask the Lord this morning, Father, you will prosper the works of my hands. Lord Almighty, abundance will be my portion. Lord, you will increase me. And for every bondage, remember the stone was rolled away on the day of Easter. I don't know which stone that had been caging you. It's a month of liberty. It's a month of freedom. You are no longer limited. That is the word of God to us this morning. And Hebrews 4:16 tells us that let us boldly come to the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Tell the Lord and say, Father, your boldness will continue to be in me. The word of God says he's a lion of the tribe of Judah. Remember, a lion is always bold and courageous. You stand before him this morning. Ask the Lord and say, Lord, let your mercy prevail. Lord in heaven, let your grace be sufficient, because the flesh in me cannot do this thing. And that, Lord, you forever be my help in the time of need. Talk to the Lord in your own way and ask the Lord again this morning. Because the word of God tells us in Hebrews 14, in Hebrews 12, he said, looking carefully, lest anyone fall short of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up cause trouble, and by this many may be defiled. What are the thoughts of your heart? Ask the Lord this morning and say, Lord, may I not be short of your grace. Lord, every bitterness in my heart, every unforgiveness, that is what Easter is all about. Take this bitterness out of me. Take this unforgiveness out of me. And that, Lord, that I will not be defiled. Father, I have come, Lord. I don't want to be defiled. Because we're still in the euphoria of Easter. Easter is forever. It's alive in us. Because if Christ did not rise, where are we? And ask the Lord and say, Lord, may my hope in you continue to be alive. The theme today says, a living hope. It's not hope lived. It's not hope that is to come. It is living. Lord Almighty, let my hope in you continue to be alive. Because remember, where there's hope, there's faith. Ask the Lord this morning, Lord, increase my faith. I don't know what faith you have carried. But the preacher told us this morning that even when you come before the Lord with expectations, that God will do more than that. Ask him and say, Father, increase my faith. And in your words, you are here, not for man, but for God. The word of God says, come, let us reason together. I don't know one thing you want the Lord to do for you. Ask the Lord in your own words, Father, do this for me. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us pray for the church and for the world. And let us thank God for his goodness. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, you promised through your Son, Jesus Christ, to hear us when we pray in faith. Strengthen Henry, our primate. Michael, our archbishop. Ifedola, our bishop. John, our archdeacon and vicar. And all the clergy and all those in the service of Christ, that those who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Bless and guide our rulers, give wisdom to all in authority, and direct that this and every nation in the ways of justice and peace, that God may honor one another and seek the common good. We pray especially for our leaders in Nigeria. Pray for Bola Ahmed Tinubu, the president. Let us remember the governor, Babajide Sanwo-Olu, the Senate president, and all those in positions of authority, that this one, O Lord, the act of flesh will continue to fail, but that the will of God will continue to prevail, that this nation will forever move forward. Give grace to our families and friends, and to all our neighbors, that we may serve Christ in one another, and love as he loves us. Pray for your family at this time. Tell the Lord and say, Father, make my family a home of peace. Make my family a heaven on earth. Bless my home. Peace will remain and the joy of the Lord remain forever in my home. Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles and bring them the joy of your salvation. Whether you have anyone in mind, mention a name. Pray for that particular person, that particular need at this time. And hear us as we remember those who have died in the faith of Christ, according to your promises. Grant us with them a share in your eternal kingdom. Rejoicing in the fellowship of all your saints, we commend ourselves and all Christian people to your unfailing love. Merciful Father, can we all share the grace and fellowship, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Please rise. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which the earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Together, yours, Lord, the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and earth is yours. All things come from you. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, it is our duty and joy at all times and in all places to give you thanks and praise. Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord, for he is your living word. Through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you have freed us from the slavery of sin, giving him to be born as man and to die upon the cross. You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Through him you have sent upon us your holy and life-giving spirit and made us a people for your own possession. Heavenly Father, we pray that you help us to understand that in you we have eternal hope. Give us the grace to live daily as people who have hope, and help us to invest our life and times in all things that has eternal value, in the name of Jesus Christ. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your glorious, great and glorious name forever, praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Please kneel. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant by the power of the Holy Spirit these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross and proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. As we look for his coming in glory, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect sacrifice. Accept through him our great high priest. This is our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your spirit. Inspire us with your love and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Almighty God, in songs of everlasting praise. take this bread to share in the body of Christ. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Together, the prayer of humble access. We do not presume to come to your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our unrighteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Draw near with faith, receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of Christ keep you in eternal life. The blood of Christ keep you in eternal life. The table is set. Communicants of the Anglican Church and other churches in communion with the Anglican Church are welcome to the table. Others should sing and pray along and endeavor to see the vicar or any of the curates after the service.
Praise the Lord. As we take the ablution hymn, we will give our offerings in their various envelopes. Give to the Lord, and he will give back to you, and he will bless all your labor in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Everlasting Father, we are grateful. We bless your holy name. We thank you for your provision. We thank you for the opportunity to bring before you this token, which is a heart of thanksgiving. Father, may this be accepted unto you in the mighty name of Jesus. Everlasting Father, we present ourselves in your name. And we pray, Father, that your abundance blessings will rain upon us in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray, Father, that your riches will continue to swim in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Through this token, I pray that the doors of victory, the doors of prosperity, the doors of breakthroughs shall be opened unto us in the mighty name of Jesus. And at the end of it all, we will continue to have reasons to give thanks to the Lord. And so shall it be in the name of Jesus. Thank you because you have answered our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed.
Jesus came and stood in the midst and said to them, "Peace be with you. The Lord be with you." Let us pray. As our Savior taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Together, Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and walk to your praise and glory. Amen.
Praise the Lord. At this time, we will have our New Month Thanksgiving. Members of Gideon Store, please put the bowl out.
The rain of miracle is falling on me today. Yeah.
Father, we thank you because indeed you have given us victory. Victory over sin, victory over death, victory over sicknesses, victory over trouble. We thank you, Lord God, for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, who gave us victory. Father, we give you thanks because you carried us from January and you have brought us safely to the month of April. Thank you for all the battles you fought for us. Thank you for the many ways you have met our needs. Thank you, Father, for disasters that you have averted. Father, may your name be glorified in the mighty name of Jesus. We hope on you, we trust in you as we continue the journey of this month. Father, we pray that our journey shall be hazard-free in the mighty name of Jesus. We will not journey into disaster. We will not embark on a journey of no return in the mighty name of Jesus. Evil shall be far from our habitations in the name of Jesus Christ. Concerning our family members, concerning our children, concerning our parents, good news shall be our portion in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray that this month the Lord will attend to you. He will bless your work. He will bless your businesses. In your career, the Lord will show up. In your home, the Lord will identify with you. The Lord will give you good health in the mighty name of Jesus. There shall be no death in your domain in the mighty name of Jesus. Peace shall dwell in your habitation, and your joy shall be full in Jesus' name. This new month, Thanksgiving, that of this month will not be your end in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will continue to be gracious to you, and with his mighty hands, he will wipe away your tears. Thank you, blessed Redeemer, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Good morning, church. And we pray that the blessing of the Lord will be your portion this week in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Everything you've been battling with, the Lord will take over that struggle in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. If today is your first day of worshiping with us, we want you to kindly rise so that we can formally welcome you. Any person fellowshipping with us for the very first time today, because you have come to fellowship with us today, may the Lord bless you specially. We appreciate you for coming on behalf of the entire family of this church. We thank you for coming and we want to see you again and again and again. And we pray that the Lord will attend to every of your needs in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. After the service, you can just wait for a few minutes outside there. There are seats and the welcoming team will attend to you. You are blessed forever in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If this week is your birthday, we want you to kindly rise so that we can celebrate with you. Okay? rejoice with you as you celebrate your birthday this week. We pray that the hand of the Lord will be upon your life. And every of your noble heart desire, the Lord will grant unto you. You will never be put to shame. The Lord will continue to grant you divine lifting in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Please be reminded that our weekly activities remain the same, Monday to Saturday. This afternoon, we have a special program at the diocesan level. The diocesan Easter cantata is taking place today at TBS. The time is 3:30 p.m. You are all invited to this program. Praise the Lord. The elders will be having their fellowship on Wednesday at 10 o'clock by the grace of God. And to also let us know that our weekly Bible study will be on Friday, by the grace of God, on Friday at 6 p.m. We are looking forward to seeing you, either physically or joining us online. And God will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We are still expecting the names of the representatives of some ministry to the Harvest Committee. If your ministry has not sent the name of two representatives to the Harvest Committee, please do so before the end of today. And God will bless you as you do so in Jesus' name. Our community hymn singing is on the 21st of April. So if you are April born, send your hymn. Or if you are April married, send your hymn to the secretariat so that we can work on those hymns. Any hymn of your choice, please let's do this. Praise the Lord. We publish the banns of marriage between Obia Nujunwa Oya and Collins Onyebuchi at Egu. If anyone has any just cause why these persons may not be lawfully married, such persons should please contact the vicar or remain silent. This is the second time of asking. We publish the banns of marriage between Olufemi Oloko and Afolabi Adenuga. If anyone has any just cause why these persons may not be lawfully married, such persons should please contact the vicar or remain silent. This is also the second time of asking. We publish the banns of marriage between Chigozim Stephanie Wono and Olayinka Samuel Fajemiroko. If anyone has any just cause why this person should not lawfully marry, such person should please contact the vicar or remain silent forever. This is the third and the last time of asking. And we pray that God will bless all these marriages in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yesterday, the welfare committee, the welfare ministry, they were at Peculia Saints Orphanage for visitation with some items. And on Saturday the 13th, they will be having welfare activities in the church in this place. So please let's note that. The Church of Nigeria Joshua Generation, a program for the youth of the Church of Nigeria, will commence tomorrow, the 8th of April, at Abuja, I think National Stadium, and it will last this Friday by the grace of God. We pray that God will grant them traveling mercies, and the program will be a blessing to them in the mighty name of Jesus. The sent forth of the Reverend Canon Ralph Egbinley and Reverend Jacob Ugunyinka, we hold next Sunday at the 10 o'clock service by the grace of God. Please register your ward or your children for confirmation, 2024 confirmation. The Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion has a program titled Samuel Mission that is directed at the children from age 1 to 15. Just as we have the guest guide, the Joshua mission is to cater for boys from age 1 to 15. So that each time the girls are having their program, the boys also will be taken care of. So that as the girls are groomed, the boys are also groomed. So that the boys that are groomed can eventually marry the boys that are groomed. So that you not be prepared girls for unprepared boys. So we'll be having prepared boy girls for prepared boys. And we pray that God will bless our children in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. From the women's corner, tomorrow is the feast of the Annunciation of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And the program is coming up at 1 p.m. at Our Savior's Church, TBS. The Shiloh session will begin at 12 noon before the main program at 1 o'clock. And we are expected to be there. So how many of us are going to be there, particularly the women? If you are sure that are going to be there, I can only see the hand of clergy wives. Praise the Lord. And so, because you are not going to be there, your offering of thanksgiving on behalf of this church that is going to be done tomorrow, you will do your own today. Members of the Guild of Steward, I crave your indulgence. They will get a retiring collection so that when they call All Souls Church there, it will not just be 5,000 naira that will be in the offering bowl for All Souls Church. We are more than that. And God will continue to bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Next Sunday is the Women's Sacrifice Card Sunday. Then our parish, by the grace of God, is hosting the Diocesan Mid-Year Thanksgiving this year. And that is coming up around June, by the grace of God. And it's going to be a huge gathering of people. And we are going to cater for everything, including the gift items. And we are thinking that instead of going to the market to buy gift items, we can give them food pack. We can give them food pack. So if you have Maggi, if you have tomatoes, if you have a small granite oil bottle, if you have spaghetti, if you have Indomie, all these things, we can donate them to the church. We put them together and we'll give them as pack. Rice, beans, garri, whatever. We pray that we will never be in want of anything good in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We want to draw your attention to the funeral arrangement of Mrs. Felicia Adesanya Thomas Ogunrotimi on page 10, item 24. Please, the details are there. We can go through them. You are blessed forever in Jesus' name. We'll look at Zechariah 3, 4. Please, I crave your indulgence. Let us rise. Zechariah chapter 3, verse 4. Shall we take it together? Then he answered and spoke to them, to those who stood before him, saying, take away the filthy garment from him. And to him he said, see, I have removed your iniquities from you, and I will clothe you with rich robes. Praise the Lord. The passage speaks about Joshua the high priest when he appeared before the angel of the Lord, and Satan was standing right at his right hand accusing him. And God rebuked the devil because of him. And I pray for you today that any voice of accusation speaking against you or against your children, they remain silent forever in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. And God said that remove the garment from him, the filthy garment that he was putting on, the garment of sin and reproach. Today, because you appear in the sanctuary of the Almighty, your garment of shame is taken away. Every garment of backwardness is taken away. The garment of trouble and sickness and failures, they are taken away. The garment of untimely death is taken away. The garment of righteousness and holiness is put upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. You will continue to wear the garment of honor in the mighty name of Jesus. The garment of good health, the garment of longevity, the garment of prosperity is your portion in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will put upon your children, wherever they are, the garment of honor in the mighty name of Jesus. None of them shall suffer disgrace in the mighty name of Jesus. Regarding your children, you will continue to have joy in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It is well with you. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. They are sung once.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. The peace of God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.